forward about the interview. I'm very interesting about this, and I would like to know how are they going to. Okay, you already said that they'll use the emails to, because I had my contacts and emails on the form, right?
Yes.
So when it comes to interview at the embassy, what are the procedures and what should I do? I as an applicant, what should I do and what should I get ready for? Like, okay, how can I get ready for that? Like,
Okay.
preparing myself.
So after winning, there are three to four major steps. Step number one, you check the results you have won. You are supposed to fill, that's what we usually say, oh, DS 260, DS 260. But that is a visa application form. If someone is going to the US as a student or visitor, is filling the form 160, 160, non-immigrant. If you are the winner for the DV lottery, you fill the DS 260, which is immigrant visa application form. So the first thing, you fill the application form. When you apply for the lottery, you just say, I have bachelor degree, I have primary education, I have masters. But if you win, now you are going to say, I went to University of KwaZulu-Natal, PO Box, this one, KwaZulu-Natal, I studied this particular program from this year to this year. If you say, I worked from, let's say, Exim Bank, you have to say, I worked from Exim Bank in the Dar es Salaam branch on this address from this day to this day, and this is my supervisor. So you, on the visa form, you are going to actually put exact work experience and you're going to put exact education. So it's a very long form. And if you are married, that is when you are going to add information of your spouse and the information of your children, if you have children. And by children, not the child of your relative, is your biological child or stepchild
Exactly.
or adopted. By adoption, must be a legal adoption by the court of law.
Yeah.
So you fill the form. Once you fill the form, you submit. Once you submit, you wait. Then there is something, there's offices called Kentucky Consular Center, KCC. The KCC is in charge of processing people to be ready for the interview. So in that process, they will send you, at one point, they will send you the email. Which is the email which you used to apply and the email you used to put in the DS 260 visa form that send the following documents. So you have to submit the documents. And by documents, you are going to submit the birth certificate, if you are married, marriage certificate, passport page, police clearance. You have to, in any country you have lived for more than 6 months, you have to put that one. But for children under the age of 16, they don't need police clearance. So you have to send those documents. If you have been to the prison, you have to submit the prison document. You don't send education or work experience documentation up to that moment. They needed just a few documents. So you send it to the KCC, Kentucky Consular Center. Then there is another process. The Kentucky Consular Center or the Department of State, which is in charge of the visas, is sending something that's called a visa bulletin. So each month they are telling you, we are going to interview group from number this one, maybe 1 to 2,000. So if you are CAS number is the number you are given after winning. It's between that range. That is when your month of application. So then they are sending you the email. Your interview date is on this day at the local embassy in your country. So from that moment you go. So before you go to the interview, you are given the information 6 weeks at least before, so that you can do the medical checkup,
Check up.
you and your family, if you are coming with a family. And then from there, you will be going to the visa interview. So the same documents used for the KCC are the same documents, but in addition to that, you are going to add education and work experience documents. That's the documents which are different from the KCC, just addition of the two documents.
Let me ask this for the applicants who are in marriage as a husband and wife. Let's say they won the DV lottery. The moment they're waiting for the answers, for the results, what are you advising them? Like, are they supposed to be ready for anything? Like, okay, they've been re maybe they have already won the DV lottery,
Yes.
and they have maybe four or three kids.
Yes.
Is that okay for them to start preparing for the passports
Yes.
for the kids?
The day you win, there is the day you win, because you cannot complete the visa form without the passport.
Yeah.
Because Also, these kids, even if the child is 1 day old, is supposed to have a passport, okay, because in the end they have to have a stamp, okay, so they're going to be allowed to enter in America.
Okay.
So you, yes, you have to get, those are the costs which you have to go, because if you're applying as husband and wife, mm-hmm, a child doesn't have a passport, doesn't need to have a passport because he's a minor, yeah, will be part of it. But if you win, yes, you have to get the passport ready.
Yeah, I wanted to make the people understand there is two different things. While you're applying as a husband and wife, you need to have the passport.
Yes.
Not children's. But the moment that you won, you have to get a passport for all of your family,
because
right?
they need that one.
Yeah, that is what I wanted them to know.
Yes.
Okay. We are, as applicants, already won the DV lottery. He or she already did the interview. So what next? I know they will give you a little bit of time, like maybe 4 or 3 months.
6 months, max.
6 months, yeah. Okay. For you to get ready.
Yeah.
Are they giving you... do they give you the ticket? Do they pay for anything? Or as an applicant, you need to get ready for everything, expenses,
yes,
for traveling and everything.
I wish they could give you something. They don't give you any amount of money.
Okay.
Because the green card itself, mm-hmm, is huge. It's more than 2,000, 5,000. In the US, people struggle even for 10 years, 15, 20 years to find the opportunity to get that green card, but they don't get it.
Mm-hmm.
So US government, when they give you green card, is more than the amount of any money they could give you.
Yeah.
So ticket is on your own. The money to start your life is on your own. They don't give you, they don't tell you where to go to live in America. They don't tell you, or give you the job. It's your responsibility. If you're a millionaire, you don't need to work. It's good,
mm-hmm,
for you. But it's up to you. Once you are there, yes, there are each state, each city, they have their own job centers, or you can go to the staffing agents, you can go apply online, you can find a job,
mm-hmm,
your host can support you, help you in one way or another.
Okay.
But basically, all the US government is giving you the green card, which is a green light to work to any employer and to live in America without any extra authorization required. So that is huge, and is more than flight ticket, if they have to give flight ticket.
Okay. I have like two strange questions.
Yes.
First of all, I would like to know, as for your experience, does it ever happen for a person who applied for DV lottery and won and without having a host in America? That first.
Yes.
The second question, is that must to have a host in America? And if you're supposed to have the host, why?
Okay.
And
so
if you don't have, what should a person do?
So the first one, so many people have won DV lottery without having a host or knowing anybody in America.
Mm-hmm.
The purpose of the host, when you are filling the visa form, there is no question who is your host.
Mm-hmm.
The question is, write the address where you'll be staying in America. The address where they will send the card. So they don't care, but because we are poor, that's why we are looking for someone. Can you host me? Can I stay at your house for a month? But if you have your own money and you rent your apartment and you want before you go to America,
okay,
and put that address, is it allowed? What the US Embassy wants is, where are you going to stay? You're not going to be homeless. And where are we going to send the actual green card? Because when you are given, it will be a visa stamp on your passport. But when you go there, they'll give you the card in America.
Okay.
So there are so many people have won the DV lottery without. One guy, for instance, won the DV lottery,
mm-hmm,
didn't have, is Tanzanian,
mm-hmm,
was struggling to get someone. So while I was in Tanzania at that time, it was 2016, 2017,
mm-hmm,
I mean 2017, I think. So I connected with a friend of mine.
Okay.
And say, oh, the person can come and stay 1 month, but up to now they have been there together. They live together like for 3 years.
Wow.
Yeah. So that is happening. They didn't know each other until I connected them together. There is one person in Zambia who was asking me if I can host, but unfortunately I have someone.
Mm-hmm.
So you can find a host on your own.
Mm-hmm.
So how to find a host? The biggest part is to win. Once you win, for instance, let's say you are Kenyan.
Mm-hmm.
You go to the website, you go to the Facebook, find Kenyan diaspora in the US,
mm-hmm,
or Kenyan in Texas, Kenyan in whatever. you are Nigerian or you are Ghana, find the people from West Africa. So you just post it there. I would like to post a question here. I have won the DV lottery and I'm supposed to come to America. I'm looking a place where I can stay for at least a month. Just a place to stay so someone can agree to use the address and where you can stay there for a month. That's number one. If you are Christian, Anglican, find the Anglican church, write to the pastor. If you're Catholic, write to your priest. If you're Muslim, find a mosque and write to Imam. The point is, there will be someone who is willing to help you to stay for a month.
Yeah.
That's another thing. Or you can just say, oh, I'm from East Africa. Can I find someone? And this is the point where I tell people, who do you follow on Instagram? Who do you follow on Twitter? Yeah. Who do you follow on Facebook? Mm-hmm. It's okay, not bad, to have Eric Omondi, Diamondi, Harmonize, Davido, Alikiba, to follow them. But also follow other people who can add value beyond entertainment and
exactly.
gossip. Yeah. So if you win, because I'm giving example, I know you, if you win to say I can host to be easier, like from, I do not know from day one, can you host me? I would say no.
It's
but if you have chatted online, it helps. And another thing, sometimes you might see, assume you failed to get a host. Someone say, I cannot host you. You can say, in order to complete the visa form, can I use your address? Like, you are coming to stay at my address, so I'll put you as a host, but you will not come to stay at me with me.
Yeah.
So the card will send to me, then I'll find you whatever address. So you can process the visa like you're coming to me, but once you get the host, whatever, you can find a place to stay. You don't stay with me, but the card will come to me. You are allowed to do that too.
Okay.
So as long as US Embassy wants to know where you are going to stay, they don't want to come here to come as homeless.
Okay, please help a person who thinks that to apply DV lottery or to have this opportunity to go to America or another country, it's just for educated people. Please, can you help them? Because somebody might think like, okay, this thing is for only educated people. I am not educated. What am I going to do in America? Blah, 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 and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Can you help them, please?
Number one, the DV or diversity visa lottery application doesn't care the level of education. Yes. The minimum requirement is at least high school.
Mm-hmm.
But what if you don't have high school? You need to have 2 years of qualifying work experience.
Yeah.
If you are a mechanic, did you go to a trade school, to vocation training?
Mm-hmm.
If you go to you went to vocation training, now where do you work? They look all those kind of things, then you are going to get.
Mm-hmm.
I know someone from Uganda was primary school education was like over 50 and came to America. So number one, the selection of DV lottery doesn't care the level of education. But the related question to that is, can you survive in America if you don't have a degree? Yes. Majority of Americans don't have a degree. I can say over 60%, 70% of Americans don't have a degree. In Africa, we study a lot because that is the only means of surviving is having a degree or having masters. Here is a normal education, but in America is a very, very high education. If you find the people with age of 60 and above, in 10 people, 7 to 8, they don't have a degree. Because for them, high school, they finished, they went to the community college, or they went to become a mechanic, plumber, or something like that, and they've been working. And someone, even if you go there, your primary education, your job will be maybe carrying the boxes from Amazon, just light boxes from one to another, $15 per hour.
Mm-hmm.
Meaning you are going to make nearby $3,000 before overtime in a month.
Mm-hmm.
But if you stay in your country with your primary education, I don't believe you'll make more than $200 or $100 per month. So the jobs are there. And you can, after arriving there, you can start. If you didn't have high school, you can take what they call GED. It's just like equivalence education for high school. You take the test and then you can do your bachelor degree. You can do master's, PhD, whatever you want, you can do that. And even if you study maybe social science here, you are in America and you want to become a doctor, you are allowed. In the US, there is no, oh, I studied social science, I cannot become a doctor because I didn't study the combination for science to become a doctor. In the US, you can be anybody, you can go to school and do that.
Okay, I have a funny question.
Yes, please.
Okay, I've been going through some YouTube channels for border patrols and stuff like that.
Yes.
So one of the funny things is, and one of the scary things that I'm always worried about it is carrying some kind of food, carrying some kind of materials, which will cause you problem and you might get yourself they get you back and take you back to your home country. So I would like to know, but as for me, I won't carry anything or
yeah.
in Nigerian voice. I won't carry anything because I don't want to take to be taken back. So I would like to, I know there's this kind of a people who love to
carry some food,
some spices from their home places in different countries because we're coming from different parts of,
yes.
of the Africa. So I would like you to help this kind of a person who likes to carry such stuffs.
Yes.
What is advantage and disadvantage of that?
Okay.
Maybe it might help someone who is listening right now and who is already planning of carrying some bunch of
fufu and the old crazy things.
And
yeah.
All crazy things and stuff. Because like a food, you get the food in on a plane. That is what I know. So, what are you advising this about this issue?